Okay, this is going to be kind of an interesting video. Probably more for my subscribers than the thing that kind of came out of my last two Carcano videos I did, anyway. It's kind of an interesting turn of events. Kind of funny, kind of sad. I could make a whole bunch of videos over the stuff that I've sort of learned in the last couple days about this and where these videos were going. And because I had a character, he sent me a private message and he was asking about if I could load more than 7 rounds. And so I said, oh yeah. So I made the first video. I didn't actually physically put 7 rounds in the gun. I just showed that it was theoretically possible. And then Core 49 left a message on that day. He's like, well, I got a private message from, I guess, it was the same guy. It is the same guy, pretty sure. And he's like, oh, I made a video, but I didn't post it yet. So then he posted his video. He showed, I showed that it was theoretically possible with some guns, or the one gun I tested at the time. I didn't try it with the other ones. It was that 9138 TS I tried it with initially. It works, but it's sort of a little bit not perfect. He posted a video with his gun. He showed that it wouldn't work. So, okay. So then, the guy that private messaged me that I made the first video for, he was kind of, in my opinion, it seemed like he was kind of put out that the video wasn't clear enough or obvious enough or whatever. So I was kind of wondering, what's going on? What is this even about? So I made a second video, and I went through 3 different guns. 2 of them did it. The 9138, as I mentioned, it was, it's not the best, but it will work. It will, you can load 7 rounds. My 1941 rifle, you can push the rounds. There's more movement in the gun, and it's a lot easier. And the 91 rifle, you wouldn't do it at all, so it's 6 rounds and that's it. So then I posted that video, and then Core 49 left a weird comment that he's like, oh, you're trying to you had to make me, or had to prove me wrong or something, which I don't understand where he got that from, but, because I posted the second videos because the guy that private messaged me the first time didn't seem to put out, and I was stupid enough to clarify things, and plus in my first video, I showed that it was theoretically possible to load 7 rounds. And he posted a video right after that showed that you couldn't. So how was my third video trying to? I don't know. Hopefully he doesn't think I was my second video was to try to disprove his video or whatever. Because I showed that one of my guns wouldn't do it. So it's just the luck of the draw. Like some of them will, some won't. It has to do with more or less how much the magazine is inletted into the stock. Somebody got the notion that it was, if the gun is worn or something, that it would do it, and I don't believe that is true, because my 9138 is basically, was unissued before it was, sold surplus. My 1941 rifle shows almost, zero use, everything is, the stampings are all crisp, the blue, there's no excessive wear that I can, or any, hardly, there's very minimal wear anywhere on the bolt or anything. I don't know where they got that idea, but it has to do with how much the bloody mag is, inletted into the stock, so I was getting that, and the little steel collars that are in, that stop the bolts from, so anyway, the second video I made, I was asking, how does this have to do with anything? So I got a couple comments from different, I think it was one guy at least. They said, oh, there's this ongoing argument on this forum, and it's a JFK assassination forum. And so I just Googled that, looked it up, found a thread that was called Clip. And guess what videos I found there? My videos. So this character that sent me private messages didn't even tell me that I was totally ignorant of what was going on. And that's another funny thing, is a couple of people, as I read through the comments, they were accusing me of, or one guy, I guess, he thinks that, oh, I was you know, faking it or doing something. Like, I had no idea what the hell was going on until after this. I kind of had it in my mind. It was like, because the way he was kind of like, you do a video about this, and then when it didn't really show definitely one way or the other, he was kind of put out, and I was like, these people must be looking, you using this, you know, in somewhere or something. Anyway, this thread that I found my videos in, it's like 2 years old. It's been going on for like 2 years, like 2014, I guess, when they started it. It's been ongoing. And guess there's other videos I found there. He has a number for his channel name. I'll just put that out there. Anyway, and I'll post a link to the thread down below. You can go through it. It's kind of hard to follow because it's sort of a, as most arguments or conspiracy kind of things go, there's, you get your facts, and then you get your kind of your opinion, and then they mix together, and then it's kind of hard to follow what, and it sort of turns into a mental exercise to try to, it's just a debate, you know, debate or whatever, you know, people, they try to push people into a corner certain ways, or pick holes in things, and, but it was kind of funny because the guy that said that you could load 7 rounds in the Carcano, the FBI guy that was on the, at the Warren Commission or whatever, I guess the whole thing is that some people, if they fear they can discredit something he said, that you can discredit everything he said, pick holes in it that way. So then they tried to pick holes in my videos that I was trying to mislead people somehow or something. It's... Because they even said, like in the first video, I only had the 6 dummy rounds I had to mess with. I'm not loading live ammo in the host. Like, so all I had was 6, so I took one out and loaded, 5 in the mag, and then I could push the mag down enough they could get the round to go over top. So, oh, that's not it. It's still 6. You guys can count. That's good. Like, I want to give a little bit of background here, too. Like, I've been on YouTube, 10 years. I've argued with a lot of people. These little weird arguments that people come up with, they don't really impress me a whole lot. And the I've read a lot, a bunch of the comments on the thread there. Like, I think it starts, it's up to, 169 or something pages of posts now. I think it's, if you go back, it starts to about 141, I think, is when they post my videos. And then it goes from there. But they even, I was like, okay, well, in the second video, I will take one round out, and I put a fired casing in to take up the space so I could load 6 in and then put the 7th on top. You guys following me? This is getting kind of complicated here. But they figured that, one guy said that having this casing here gives you more movement so you can get the 7th round in, but I had already shown, in the other, the first video was, I had a clip that had the 6 rounds in it, and I still had enough room to push it down and put the bolt over top of it. So there's no reason why that would change anything if there was a spent shell, which it doesn't do anything. The follower doesn't push on the bullet. It's like, pushes here. It doesn't let it go tilt forward. There's little grooves for it to ride in. I totally, open left field here, I don't know. I could take this, I could put this, in the freaking middle here somewhere. I could put it in there, that make you happy? I'm tempted to make another video and go over it, because there's, I'd have to go through and write down all the weird arguments they come up with that try to debunk me. I didn't know what the hell was going on in the first place. I wasn't trying to deceive anybody or anything. But now they're trying to undermine my videos, but oh, he's doing this, or he's doing that, or he had to hammer the bolt shut with his hand. I said it was scraping the top of the casing. That's not hammering the bolt shut. I've had guns where I had to hammer the bolt shut. And then they say, well, if it's that hard to close, then it's way probably harder to open. Because when you fire the casing, it expands and it's hard to extract. It's like, do people know any, these people know anything about metallurgy or how a brass case works? It's small initially, you fire it, but when brass expands, it has a little bit of memory. It expands, and then it gets a tiny bit smaller there. Like, it's not that hard to pull out. Like, I've had... That's what she said. Anyway, I've had casings that weren't sized properly. They were a hell of a thing to hammer in, but as soon as you fired them, they fireformed themselves, and they were easy to snot to pull out. That's why they use brass casing. It has the best balance of integrity, slickness. It'll expand and seal the chambers. You don't get gas leakage and stuff, but it'll actually kind of rebound a little bit after you fire it, so it can be easily extracted. It won't get stuck in the chamber. Like, you know, there's always differences to that rule. Like, if excessive pressure, sometimes it gets swelled up so bad that it has some issues and stuff. But some of us reading, like, this is stuff, this is... Like, people argue with things they have no idea about. Like, I don't know about all this stuff either, but I know enough that most of the stuff I guess there's one or two characters on there that these arguments they tried to field against me or use to debunk my videos that I did in good faith. I had no idea what the hell this private message I got, where these videos were going or what he was using them for. He was even posting the private messages that he was going back and forth with me with. I didn't know anything about this, but now that I do, I was like, yeah, I can go and I see your message now. I can debunk all these stupid arguments that you use. Because pretty much, I think 100% of them pretty much I can probably debunk. But as I just mentioned, so. Anyway, it was kind of interesting, kind of funny, kind of sad at the same time. Like, I think these are like middle-aged men that are, their arguments are terrible. Like, I run into a lot of stuff on the internet and on YouTube and, well, however long I've been on the internet. These arguments are terrible. It's just that you don't know anything about the guns and how they work, the basics of some things. They're just, they don't even have to be just Carcano specific. They're like, this applies to pretty much every gun going, pretty, you know, in a lot of ways. And how cartridges work and so forth. And but anyway, it's just brutal. So anyway. So I'll post the forum down below if you want to read through it. I think it goes back to about, I think it's 141 is where they start. Like, I think they post my video the first time or something. I think that's how it works. So yeah, so the people that are sort of supported me, like, I really appreciate it. Like, I had got some really good comments from the videos I made. The people that were sort of thought the other guy was full of shit, I guess. But even the guy that wanted the video I made in the first place, I think he's kind of on the fence, or he kind of thinks that the 7-shot thing was kind of a lie or something from the start, and I think he kind of wanted to use me as a pawn to try to prove it or something, and maybe that's why he wasn't so happy when I showed that it probably was possible. Like, it's possible with some guns. Like, nobody's, if you people handled the one that, you know, like the Oswald gun, like, if you guys tried that one, so until you actually get that one in your hands, you can go fly a kite, basically, because, you know, like, so unless you can find some other people, you know, like, if a couple will do it, then there's a lot more than a couple will do it. And they even, I think I even mentioned that, well, if you loosen the magazine, then it'll work. So I knew nothing what the hell you guys were up to initially. And then, I loosened the screws of my magazine so it would work. And then I would, in one video, I would show that two would do it, like, two guns would do it. One wasn't very good. One was fairly easy. The third one wouldn't do it at all. Like, if I was out to deceive somebody, I think I'd even put that in the video. Like, I'll probably do it just to cover up my tracks or something. Like, these are, like, maybe people, like, 12 or, like, in grade 3 or something. Like, this is, like, these are horrible, horrible arguments, you know. Like, the one other kind of funny thing about it is, I've been watching the show off and on for years. It's the Atheist Experience. It's in Austin, Texas. And there's one of the guys on the show, I don't know if he's a producer of the show, or he does something. He's on the show once in a while, John, Iocoletti, I guess is how he's pronounced his last name, I'm not so sure. He got an Italian name, so he's obviously biased towards Carcanos, right? Anyway, I saw him on these forums. That's kind of a weird coincidence somehow, I don't know. But apparently, I guess when you're not arguing the great debate, I guess the Kennedy conspiracy or the Kennedy assassination is the next best thing, because it's sort of, I guess, follows the same kind of traits as arguing about is there a God or not, because it's sort of your arguing with something that there's not a lot of facts left, or the facts are so boogered up that it's hard. It's kind of an argument that can go on forever. They're kind of a nice argument, people that like to debate about things, because they'll never be settled, like, because you get, like, you know, like the Warren Commission here is your Bible. I actually bought this at the while back for like 50 cents or something somewhere. Just published in October 1964, so it was one of the early ones, I guess. So I got that. And I even got from the Western Cartridge Company ammo, which was apparently the ammo that Oswald had, I think. I don't know. But, ooh, look at that. It's the real stuff. But, and no, I'm not firing any of it. I think it's worth too much now. Let's, like, set up a Patreon and you guys give donations, you know, give me some big money, and then I'll shoot off some of these, do some accuracy testing or something like that. But so anyway, it's kind of funny turn of events. Some little stupid video I made. It was seemed to have a fairly big impact on a bunch of people on some forum somewhere. That's probably why I don't go to forums anymore, because it seems like a lot of bad stuff comes on forums. Just lucky I'm so hard up for video ideas that people can feed me stupid private messages. Like, my video or my channel's not big or anything, but, like, a lot of channels won't even do this kind of stuff for people. People ask me, oh, yeah, sure, I can make a video, and you're right down my alley. Like, I can make a video one go and easy to set up a stupid camera, get it with my stupid Carcano, can practice around, bam, I can make a video right quick. Like, that's perfect for me. I love that kind of stuff. Video takes a little bit of work or a little bit too much editing. No, it ain't gonna work. So, anyway. So, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll talk to you later.